All right.
You've got on a NASA shirt too, don't you?
I love it. I love a NASA shirt. Yeah.
Thank you so much. Wrenn and Krys, you know, absolutely love you two, you two's character. The essence of a strong woman is defined through the roots of both of your characters. I want to start off with you, Krys. Danielle, I absolutely think defines the title for all mankind. Everything she does is beyond her. She's always thinking about the bigger picture. She's very selfless. This season, we see her go through some really tough conversations with Clayton's sisters, with Ed, we see her struggles, yet the resilience, healing from the past, the struggle, discrimination, the prejudice, speaking up for herself with pride, like literally breaking down barriers. Episode 4 is amazing, all of it, by the way.
Yeah.
I just want to know, what type of emotions, responsibilities do you have in taking a role like this? And do you ever find yourself pulling inspiration from your personal life into Danielle?
Always. Yeah. I mean, every time Danny walks into a room, she's usually the only Black woman there. That is not an unfamiliar feeling for me. So I know what that's like. I know intimately what it feels like to feel like, even if you're amongst a group of people who love you, that there is a sense that you have to be at your best, that you are representative of not just yourself, but of everybody else like you. And that you're under the microscope in many ways. So there are some aspects about Danielle, like her knowledge of science and technology and engineering, that I have very little information about and need a ton of research for. But when it comes to what it's like to be in a relationship with a man who, you know, who needs to be lifted up, when she knows the exchange of demanding more, as you said, those are not unfamiliar paradigms for me. And those are the parts about Danielle that feel like they don't really take any acting. They feel like they come pretty naturally.
Yes, I love her stance for women rights and African-American rights. There's some, again, episode 4, very, very good.
Thank you. Thank you.
Now, Wrenn, Margot is a character who constantly has to make the hard decisions, and season 2 is no different. However, this season we see her loosening up a little bit, having some comedic and awkward moments, and even showing a little bit of vulnerability. And the miss is still having to make the hard decisions. So would you ever say that Margot's mind was ever taken off of her duties while enjoying this other side of herself that we haven't seen thus in 2 seasons?
I don't think so. I feel like for Margot, work is never out of her sight line. But I do think that one of the big secrets about Margot is that she's actually a really well-rounded human being, and she's an accomplished pianist. She actually has a great sense of humor. But she's just really private about that, because I think for her, especially being a woman in the 1960s at NASA, like all of those things feel like a liability, like they make her vulnerable in a way that she just can't afford to be, and is maybe in some ways like on a different path than Danny, but I think in some ways connected, because she cannot mess up. She has to be perfect. And I think that's one of the things that really changes in the second season, is that pressure to be perfect and to not have like any kind of vulnerability has kind of faded away a bit. Like, she's the head of the Johnson Space Center. And, you know, I think there's like a relaxed, you know, confident quality to her in the season that's so fun to play. But I do think that Margot is somebody, you know, she says in the first season, you know, like, she's not really interested in having kids, and she's not, you know, like, her work is her life. It's her love, you know? So, you know, I think for her, it's always present, but you know, it's going to be interesting to see how the audience feels about these, I don't know,
distractions.
I know they're gonna love the moment when she's caught, shall I say, off guard at work. I know they're gonna absolutely love it.
Totally.
Well, again, I cannot wait for what happens season 3. You two characters are gonna be the catalyst of it. I can see it coming, but as of right now, season 2, you know, thank you so much for this. The fans are gonna be head over heels when they see the things that come from the two of you. And it's a pleasure.
Thank you, Najir. Thank you so much for being here.
No problem. I hope you have a good rest of your day. Take care.
Thanks, you too.